morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. Well, my dear friend, Mr. Eric Solem, Executive Director, UN Environment. Mr. Vishal Kapoor, the National President for Indian Society of Heating. Mr. C. Subramaniam, Air. Mr. Bajalme W. Olison. Mr. Frank Havarka. Mr. Gurmeet Singh. Mr. Rajendra Kumar Somani. And I have in this audience one of my joint secretaries from the Ministry of Environment, Government of India, Mr. Gyanesh Bharti, Mr. Atul Bagai, Head of United Nations Environment India, very distinguished and respected representatives of the industry, members of the press, media, and distinguished friends. Well, it's a very, very, I think we have Mr. Pankaj also here, he arrived later. And of course, I can see there are a lot of people in this audience who are not individuals, but they are big institutions. I wish I had the time and of course the details of each one of you to an extent that I could name all of you, but time doesn't permit. But I wish to convey my sincere gratitude to all of you for being present here, and of course I wish to thank the organizers for giving me this great privilege of being with all of you, and of course to be inaugurating this very grand event. It's not a routine exhibition, it's a professional scientific exhibition of professionals, organized by the professionals, and I think it's a very high quality professional activity. I've been to many exhibitions in my 25 years of public life, but I can say that amount of pleasure and satisfaction and pride that I derive after coming here and visiting this exhibition, it's beyond my vocabulary and linguistic ability to describe that amount of pleasure. Just referring to and thanking my dear friend Eric for the kind words that he made about the story of polio eradication in India. So when he referred to this, I was just thinking that a large credit for having a polio-free India, I think it goes to all of you. And you have clapped, but you probably don't realize why I don't say why I say that. 25 years back, when I became the health minister in Delhi, and I was told that India is home to 60% of the polio cases of the whole world, and there was a strategy by which we could eradicate polio like we could do the smallpox in the 70s. There were hardly any, it came as an information to me, but when we started talking about eradicating polio or working on that, everybody used to tell us, how is it possible in a country like India? Number one, a vast country like India, where you have to provide polio vaccine to every child, millions of, hundreds of millions of children at the same time, on the same day, within a span of few hours. And then the biggest challenge that was told to me, and which of course we could appreciate, was that how will you get the cold chain for making the vaccine available at far off places, almost covering 6 lakh villages and remotest areas of this country. So I had only one answer to all this, that if this country can provide ballot papers to everyone on a single day, why can't the same country provide 2 drops of vaccine to every child on the same day? And we could do it together. But I'm sure that without the support and without the help, and without the contribution of the industry that I see here, we could have provided the polio vaccine at minus 20 degrees centigrade to millions of children in this country, even in the remotest part of India. So that's why I say that a large amount of significant credit for making the story of polio eradication successful in India, it goes to all of you. So I have to thank all of you for that, because Eric reminded me about the polio eradication story, because for last 7 years we haven't seen a case of polio. For 4 years we are a certified polio free nation from WHO, so we no longer in fact talk so frequently about it in our public meetings, but since he reminded about it, so I thought I should recall and place on record the contribution of the industry related to whether it is cooling or heating or refrigeration or air conditioning. And I think it is a it's a great feeling to see that professionals like you are fulfilling your professional social responsibility in such a fantastic manner, with so much of sincerity, trying to put your heart and soul into all this movement. I was told that the association has over 40 chapters all over the country, with almost 25,000 active members, and then you have representation from 25 big countries of the whole world in this particular event. I think that speaks volumes about your commitment, your sincerity, your dedication and your vision. My dear Eric was referring to the Montreal declaration, and then I have to say that there was later on a Kigali amendment to that agreement to ensure that we get rid of the ozone depleting substances, and we use you can say all those climate change or global warming potential things, we decrease them as best as possible. You will be very happy to know that in Montreal, India got international award for implementing the Kigali amendment of the Montreal declaration with the utmost sincerity, utmost conviction and utmost honesty. And now also I have to inform this August gathering that you all are aware of the Paris agreement, because it got a lot of limelight not only in India but all across the world. And we in Indians remember the Paris agreement because of our dynamic Prime Minister Narendra Modi giving a great, you can say, leadership, providing a great leadership at that Paris meeting. And on 30th of November 2015, in the Paris agreement, I think this mission innovation was started. And it was our Prime Minister Narendra Modi who in fact coined the word mission innovation, and who proposed to the whole world the mission innovation, who proposed to the whole world along with the French president about the International Solar Alliance. And Mr. Eric, I have to place on record that after that Paris, I went to two meetings. One was in San Francisco and the other one in the following year was in China. And in both these meetings, they were the clean ministerial meetings, and these were the mission innovation meetings. Because you all know that in the mission innovation, there are seven grand challenges that the world is, I think, world has put down on paper to work and do the research on them, to see how we can have these clean energy strategies, energy efficient strategies, and put all the research of the with the help of the government sector as well as the private sector, corporate world together. And India in fact is leading three out of the seven areas in those grand challenges is smart grid and off grid and biofuels. These are the end in both the meetings which I attended in San Francisco and then in China. All the world leaders, they were attended by 23 big countries, all the world leaders, they appreciated the stand of India. We all know that it is not only talking about it, but even you know the Ujala program is a huge program in which we have already had 280 million LED bulbs, LED bulbs already distributed, and double this amount being already distributed by the private sector, and also a very ambitious program of taking the super efficient air conditioners for government buildings. I think a huge number of these super efficient air conditioners are being purchased by the government to put all across the country on buildings. So there is a very ambitious program, and it's not happening at that level, but I think with the national skill mission also, there is a very ambitious program of at least training and providing skills to over a lakh of technicians in the air conditioning and the cooling industry. There is a plan to in fact augment the syllabus also for the ITIs, for the air conditioning and the cooling technicians, because we know that this is an issue which is in fact the issue also gains you can say its importance and strength and its complications with the fast growing economy that we have all world, because there is hardly any place that we can imagine, whether it's a government building or a commercial building, or whether it's a rail or a ship or a car or a house or wherever, everywhere you have the cooling system in place and the cold chain in place. Even for the farmers, we are thinking of doubling their income by the year 2022. There also you need the cooling system, the storage capacities, and we all know that the biggest emitter for one of the third most important emitter for greenhouse gas emissions is in fact the wasted food, and that's all wasted because we are not able to store it properly. And if we are not able to store it properly, then there's a problem of all this climate change and global warming. So friends, there are so many things that I can talk. But I think I can on this forum commit to all of you, number one, to all of you, that the government is very serious and sincere, not only to address the issues related to strengthening the use of non-ozone depleting substances and related issues, but also to provide all possible technical professional support to all of you, to work in close collaboration with the industry, with the corporate world. And also for the first time, we have in 2017, we have put a very powerful committee in action for a national cooling action program, which is an integrated action plan which will take care of all the sectors. And I was very happy when Vishalji told me that your association is helping 250 engineering colleges, and you are in fact helping them by supporting in their research activities for the young engineering graduates. So I think only 2 days back we officially declared, and this year you will be very happy to know that 5th of June we are celebrating the World Environment Day in India. India is host to the World Environment Day celebrations for the whole world. We declared it officially in New Delhi with the presence of Mr. Eric there, and both of us drove in a this electric vehicle from the UN headquarters to my office together, and that's where we are initiating that great movement where by the year 2030 we propose to have all electric vehicles in this country. We propose to have 175 gigawatts of clean energy, solar energy, by the year 2022. And we want to put everything, every action in place. Finally, I think I have to tell you that we don't want to do all this as a routine measure, as a symbolic activity. I have assured Mr. Eric also that whatever India will do, we'll live up to the expectation of the whole world. We'll try to develop a model for the whole, can be emulated by everyone in this whole world, all our people, everybody in the society, all our professional bodies, NGOs, RWAs, engineers, doctors, everyone will be participating very aggressively, very proactively in the movement to ensure that we restore our environment, we work for its protection, we work for its conservation, because we strongly believe that what we talk about, all these cooling issues and these chemicals and these ozone depleting things, these are not technical issues for us. They are moral issues for us, because we feel that this is our duty for the children who are not yet born in this world, who are not yet born in India. We have to protect their rights. And to protect their right, we have to act fast now. We have to be very sincere. We have to be very honest. And I wish to inform you that we have started a movement whereby in the Ministry of Environment, we have put down more than 500 small green good deeds. I call them green good deeds because they are small actions which can be done by, you can say, performed by individuals, by organizations, by industry, by corporate world, by the builders, by school children, by teachers, by everyone in the society. And if each one of us performs one green good deed, I think in a, we will have 132 crore green good deeds performed in India. So I as you are taking care of your professional social responsibility, I call it as a green social responsibility of every Indian, for every person all across the world. And I have developed an app, Dr. Harshvardhan, in which if you download it from the Apple Store or the Google Play, you can find these 500 green good deeds there. I would like all of you to help us in developing a movement in this country around these green good deeds, so that we can create for the rest of the world a model which has been given to us by our ancestors in our DNA. You all know we got clean rivers, we got clean air, we got dense forests, we got rich fertile land, we had a very great, powerful and a very sensible relationship with the animal kingdom, and of course with nature, good quality harmony. That is all we have probably forgotten it. We have to restore it. We have to go back to our roots. We have to remember our ancestors, and we have to at least give back to our unborn children the environment that we got from our ancestors. And we promise to Mr. Eric that India is going to do it, and we are going to do it with your help. All of you professionals, engineers, thank you so much for all this great exhibition. And I'm sure with the over 50,000 visitors expected here, there will be a perceptible and measurable change all across India, all across the world, in the field of, you can say, handling issues related to refrigeration, cooling and air conditioning, etc., etc. Thank you so much. Namaskar. Jai Hind. Bharat Mata Ki Jai.